Okay. I think we have everything set up. Drinks, food, and especially snacks. I even made sure to get all your favorites, because, hey, that's what best friends do. I can see you've already eaten half of them, haven't you? I got even more downstairs of the stock cupboard, by the way. You know where it is. You've been over to my house like a million times. Anyway, now our sleepover could finally begin. So, before we watch a movie and snuggle or something, I mean, hey, if you're up to it, that is. You know, just as best friends snuggling, but anyway, what I'm getting at here is I was wondering if you could help me out with something first. See, I've been writing this story, right? And I was wondering if you could sort of give me your feedback, you know? Well, it's still in the early stages. It's more of an outline, really. But anyway, I was thinking I could quickly run you through the main points so you could tell me your thoughts. Would that be all right with you? Great, that's great. I'm glad to hear it. Okay, so where do I begin? Well, first of all, I guess I should give you the main character. So she has a girl with a hair color just like mine, and she lives in a house just like this one. And she has this friend of hers with an eye color just like yours. In fact, that she loves very, very much. Much more than just a friend. But the friend is very dense and never seems to realize it. In fact, the friend seems to be kind of slow to read in between the lines, just in general. Okay, so what do you think of my character so far? Nothing is wrong with her so far, right? Right. Nothing's wrong with her. She didn't do anything wrong. Anyway, so this girl's madly in love with her Fred. I'm talking like about 200% crazy. Head over heels, absolutely nuts in love. Her friend is making her lose her marbles. But I mean, hey, hopefully that's not the only thing that'll make her lose. But it's really difficult when the friend is so dense. Anyway, so the girl really loves her friend. But she can't confess, because what if she gets rejected? She can never take that. Keep remembering their friendship. And that's maybe the one real emotional connection she has. Everything else feels so lifeless and fake to her. So she really doesn't have the heart to confess directly. There's too much she could lose, so she tries to sort of feel things out, if you get what I'm saying. She tries to make little illusions here and there, trying to test her friend's reaction, seeing if it's okay to confess yet. Sometimes she even flirts in a sort of indirect way. But of course her friend is hopelessly dense. So this sort of method never really works for her. She even asks to snuggle a lot. And when she gets to, she always makes these flirty little remarks like, "You're so good at snuggling. I wish I was the girlfriend of someone who snuggles like you." Or something like that. The friend still doesn't get it, of course. The girl does everything. She even always makes sure to keep all the friend's favorite snacks in her cupboard. But of course, the significance of this goes unnoticed. Okay, so now, what do you think of her so far? Right? So far, so good. She didn't do anything wrong. There's nothing wrong with her trying to be indirect and test the waters. Nothing wrong with her trying to protect her relationship and her happiness. If anything, the friend should have really noticed her feelings. Am I right? But I'm still not done. Let me get on with the story. So the girl just really can't get enough of her friend. She wants to be romantic with him. She wishes they were a couple, but she just can't seize that dream. So she fantasizes a little bit. You know, innocent little fantasies. Everyone has them about their crush, right? She does too. Innocent little fantasies like holding hands with them, hugging them, getting married to them, but that's still not enough, and she wants to bring that fantasy just a little bit into reality. So she takes photos she has of her and her friend together, and then she edits it a little bit to make it look like a wedding photo, but it just at all. And it makes her so, so, so happy. to finally have a little bit of reality to your fantasy, you know? Something tangible. She looks at that photo every day, every night. She makes it her phone background. She frames a copy, even sleeps next to it. It's the one thing that gives her peace of mind when she usually always such an insomniac for not getting her happily ever after. But she can't be satisfied with that. Not with just a photo. It's still missing something. Her fantasy just still isn't physical enough. She thinks of all the times she snuggles her friend. And how lovely it would be to feel like that, even when they are around the snuggle, so... She thinks about her friend's sweater, and how if she wore that, it'd sort of feel like she was snuggling them. And she needs that. She needs that very much. So, one day, when her friend isn't paying attention, she ever so deftly swipes the sweater and replaces it with an identical one. She gets away with it completely. She keeps a straight face the entire day. She smiles to her friend as usual. She laughs with them as usual. They don't expect a thing. And she loves the sweater. She treasures it and cherishes it. And goes to sleep wearing it every night. Pretending like it was her friend all around her. Not just her sweater. And I would ask you what you think about her right about now. But I already know the answer. It's fine. She's fine. She didn't do anything wrong. She's just acting out of love. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with loving your friend who has your eye color, who has your hair color, who happens to love the exact same sex as you. There's nothing wrong with a main character being a little romantic. But it's because she's so romantic that she just can't settle down. She can't be happy with just a sweater. As great as it is, it's still just a sweater, you know? It's not as great as the real thing, and she's just torn apart that she can't spend more time with her friend. Every second that she's away from them is just eating away at her insides little by little all the time, and she just can't take it anymore. She wants to spend every waking second with them. But obviously, that's not possible. So, she starts watching that friend. It starts just watching them from behind the bushes at first, or maybe from behind a car or something. And she wakes up smiling every day knowing that today she can watch her friend again. Then, after a while, she gets an idea. She sets up cameras, very hidden cameras, the kind you wouldn't notice. She sets them up all over the places that her friend frequents, and of course she especially makes sure to set up plenty in their room. So now she can watch them all the time. They probably wouldn't let her sleep over every day, right? That would be unreasonable. But now she can watch her friend fall asleep every single day. It's almost like they're a couple. But they're not. They're not a couple. She's a great character, right? You don't have to say anything because I already know. She's fine. She's fine. She didn't do anything wrong. But, like I was saying, they're not a couple, and in a way watching her friend all the time with her cameras makes her extremely aware of that. Because yes, she can see all the things her friend does, but that also shows her all the attention they get from other people. And she just feels so... neglected. When she sees them sharing meals with others, she thinks, that should be me sharing that meal with them. When she sees them laughing and joking with others, she thinks, that should be me. When she sees them talking to others, she thinks, that should be me. And she tries to keep it together. Of course she tries. She never does anything wrong. She tries to bury her feelings deep down within her heart because she doesn't want to hurt all those people coming in between her and her friend, even though she might. She doesn't want to be destructive or hurtful, especially not around her sweetheart. But there's no way to keep a burden like that all inside, right? Her jealousy, her resentment towards her feelings of neglect, and they all get a bit more heated day after day until inevitably the entire thing boils over. So, she invites her friend over to sleep over. Just like this one, in fact. And the one thing she wants more than anything is to just be accepted, but it's so hard to even ask for that. She tries to be direct, she just stutters like a bubbling idiot. So she confesses about her feelings. She confesses about all the things she did, but she does it in a very indirect way. She confesses as if it was a character in a story that felt and did all those things. Not her. But she's worried. She's still so worried. What if she isn't accepted? But they try to run away, so she has a backup plan. She has some rope that she keeps under her bed. It looks just like my bed right here. And she drug the sacks on a Friday earlier, you know, the very same kind of sack that he helps yourself to just sell. That way they can't get away even if they wanted to. But why would they want to? She didn't do anything wrong. Don't you think so too? So, what do you think the friend will do now? Are you going to leave?